Hello everybody, and welcome to my reflection of my Vlogmas series. This series was very last minute, but I saw the other vloggers that I usually watch doing it, and I just got so excited to make all these videos that I mentioned in the I'm doing Vlogmas video that I was like, I'm just gonna do it. We're just gonna, yeah. But what I didn't think of was it's the end of the year and then I'm gonna be starting school again and I need to get things done. And Vlogmas took up a lot of that time. So in the end, I just ended up doing like kind of basic YouTuber-y videos, but they were still really, really fun. So the main reason that I did Vlogmas was next semester, I am going to be switching from the English major into the new media arts major because my dream job would be working on movies. So I wanted to practice video editing to see if film editing or being a film editor is something that I would want to do in the future. So this video is just going to be a reflection. I'm gonna go through all the videos I made. I have my family's iPad mini here to do that because I film on my phone. What I said in the I'm doing Vlogmas video is that I was gonna change my name. I don't think I'm gonna do that anymore because from here on out, it's all just gonna be Japan videos. So just ignore a lot of the things I said in that video. Maybe that'll come to fruition someday, but probably not. But okay, Vlogmas 1, IKEA and thrifting. I actually filmed this on November 27th because I wanted to like stockpile videos so that I would just have to edit them and then update them every so often. Because at first I wanted to do like every single day up until Christmas, and then I found out that I could not do that with my schedule, so it became the 12 days of Vlogmas. Just 12 random videos in between the 1st of December and the end of December, because I make up my own rules here, apparently. IKEA and thrifting, I'm really proud of this vlog. It was a lot of fun to edit, and I think it's one of the best videos from that time. The second one was filmed on the first Sunday of December, and I really like that video. I think it turned out okay. I wish the pom-poms were a little bit smaller. That's the Crafting with Claire Mickey Mouse Hat edition. It did all right. The Vlogmas 3, going to see the BTS movie and rant, was filmed on November 28th, and I don't know why I got that one out after Crafting with Claire, but I think I took a longer time to edit that one, maybe. And then Vlogmas 4, back to school slash Christmas haul. That, at this point, that's when I was like, okay, I can't do all the videos that I wanted to make, so I'm just going to do simpler videos, so at least we'll have the basic, you know, YouTuber-y things. So I bought a whole bunch of cute things from work and I did a video. And the next one too, Vlogmas 5, reacting to my first vlog. I had just found out how to put like the video in the video, and I was like, oh my gosh, I should react to my first vlog. And it actually went a whole lot better than I thought it would. Vlogmas 6 is something that I actually did plan to do, the Japan tag. That went well. Vlogmas 7 is my birthday. My birthday is actually December 5th, and I got it out on December 20th. Because it was just kind of boring footage, so I didn't want to edit it because I was like, this is going nowhere. I don't want to edit this. It's not fun to edit. So it took me a long time to edit it, but and the same with Vlogmas 8, Cooking with Claire. I had filmed that on the first Sunday too. So both those videos were filmed at the very beginning of the month, but it just took me a long time to figure out which videos would go that where and editing things. Vlogmas 9 was a week in my life. I think it was the second last week of leading up until Christmas. That was a lot of fun. I liked how I did the whole shoop shoop thing. That was like something that I thought up on the spot. I was like, oh my gosh, that would be cool. And it was weird because after I had filmed every single day of the week, afterwards I was like, oh my gosh, I still need a vlog. Why aren't I vlogging? This would be a fun thing to vlog. So it was weird vlogging every single day and then suddenly stopping because I felt like I needed to keep doing it. It was weird. And 10, Nature Walk in the Rain, was filmed on the Sunday of the week in my life. And I think it was okay. I tried to get like a really nice nature-y sound, but they didn't have a lot of good nature-y royalty-free songs on YouTube, so that's what we got. Vlogmas 11 was Memories from Japan. This was something I think my mom suggested, just showing my mementos and stuff like that. Vlogmas 12 is the Boxing Day shopping and haul. That was a last minute thing. At first, this video was going to be the 12th Vlogmas episode, but I thought it would be fun to do a Boxing Day haul because last minute I was like, oh my gosh, I want to go Boxing Day sale shopping because I found out that there was a Uniqlo at Metrotown. So I really wanted to go and sales. So there was no sales at Uniqlo, but alas. So overall, it went all right. It was a nice experience. I don't think I'll ever do it again. From now, I'm just going to release the edited videos that I have from Japan and edit the last videos that I have to make. I don't think I'm gonna film a video for a while. But the question that I got from the I'm doing Vlogmas video is, I will also put it on the screen. It is from Simply Living the Dream, and it is, I have just recently started making videos and I need practice editing too, lol. Good luck with Vlogmas. Thank you, it went all right. I would like to see your craft videos. Oh, thanks. I did one of them. My question for you is, what is your biggest goal for yourself at this point in your life? So this is also part of the reason why I wanted to practice editing and vlogging in a short amount of time. My short-term goal right now, and I put a little hint because I'm wearing a Mickey shirt, is I really, really want to do the CRP or the Cultural Representative Program at Epcot in Disney World. I would be going there as a Canadian representative and working at the Canada Pavilion in the World Showcase at Epcot. It's a one-year program and I really, really, really want to do that. I found out about it in 2016. My friend from Bible College went and did it and she introduced me to it, and that's how I found out about the DCP and started following DCP vloggers. Because not a lot of CRP people vlog their experience, or at least not a lot of Canadians. Like I followed Adam Hatton and A Clerly Tale throughout my year in Japan because that's when they were on their CRP program, but they're all from England. So a lot of English people vlog the CRP, but not a lot of Canadians. So I wanted to vlog my year in Walt Disney World. Now, this won't be happening for 2 years. I need to like save up money and work it out with school and stuff, but that is my short-term goal, and I am going to be making a new channel for that. I already have the name picked out and everything. So I wanted to practice vlogging every single day because while I'm there, I want to do like vlogging every day in April and Vlogmas. Hopefully I will succeed. But yeah, that is my goal, and it's not going to happen for a couple years because next year I'm going to be in my friend's wedding as a bridesmaid, and I really don't want to go until after 2020 anyway because that's when a lot of the like park expansions are happening. Like there's the Nintendo Land coming to the Universal over there, and like Star Wars Land and stuff like that. That's all I can think of right now. But I'm just so excited to go. I hope I get the chance to go, and so that's my goal to move towards. So this is going to be the last video of 2018. What's coming in 2019, as I said in my I'm doing Vlogmas video, is my Osaka series, my Tokyo with my friend from Canada series, and then I think I have at least 7 standalone other vlogs. Some of them are going to be like compiled extra videos, and some of them are like me going to Disney, me doing this, and then a couple of them are like vintage or forgotten vlogs because I had a Studio Ghibli Museum vlog, but I used some Ghibli music in it that I got from a CD that I bought in Japan. So I bought it myself, but just because I used the Ghibli music, they took it off of YouTube. So I need to edit that again with a new song. And the same thing with my actually coming to Japan video. I lost the footage, so I need to re-edit that. And I think that's going to be the last video on this channel. Like, what was supposed to be the first is now going to be the last. And yeah, at some point we're probably going to be getting videos released from over a year ago, but I'm not gonna have like a regular upload schedule. It's just going to be whenever I have the time with school, because I'm going to be taking 4 classes, whenever I have the time then to get the videos out. And I hope you guys will enjoy the Japan content from here on out. And thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.